Hey guys, and welcome! Okay, to this video, I'm gonna talk about some of my stories and my testimony. And I have been planning this years ago, but it is just now I have time to do it. And actually, I have shared already my testimony to my church family, but it is just only a short one because it's just only a testimony. And not including my story. So I thought it would be kind of interesting, and I personally love hearing people's testimonies, and I get to see God's hands and everything, and you know, I just love it. And I love how, you know, some of them are just like huge testimonies, and some are just like very simple but beautiful, and it touches hearts for every individual, where you will be blessed by their testimony. And so I'm gonna talk today my testimony and some of my story. And before that, I would like to thank you for all of joining today to my channel. And if you are new to my channel, please subscribe. By the way, I am Arlene Hardison. Smile. Guys, my picture when I am still single. Living in a small town of Naomi Samis Oriental, Philippines, and I have 4 brothers and 4 sisters, and I am the 3rd from the youngest. Brothers and sisters in the peak include my mom. My parents are both Catholic, and they believe in God, but they just went to church some, which is means, or in short, they don't have fully understand, or didn't have a close personal relationship with Jesus Christ, the same as me and the siblings. This is my mom and dad. They were very busy spending their time finding our daily needs, but during night time, they were devoted in prayer, prayer in rosary, and teaches us to pray. To pray at and before we go to sleep, and advise us also to go to church every Sunday. And that is why in my younger age and in my childhood, I used to go to church with some of my sisters and sometimes with my neighborhood or a friend. During my elementary school, we have religion in our class and have a teacher to teach us how to pray, how to be a good person, and to be obedient to God as well as to be good to other people. But at that time, I always believe in God. I prayed, but I'm not good as I am. I'm not obedient to God because I'll do everything what I wanted to do. And I'm not perfect. I commit sins because I do sometimes lie. In my college, I finished a course, fisheries technology. I took this course because it's only 3 courses offered in our place, and my parents cannot afford me to send to school in the city because we are many in the family are schooling. So after I graduated, I worked in the company of processing plant at AA Export and Import Corporation, Manabay, Usami City, for almost 15 years in service. So until such time that the company was temporary closed, so I was able to decide to resign my job last 2006. Then I find another job online for 2 years. Then I went back home last April 2008. So maybe this time I'll be staying at home. So it grows to my mind that maybe I'll be going to settle down. Wow. So I decided to go online searching for a friends, or if possible, more than friends. Wow. And until such time, I met my loving husband, Janwin Hardison, last July 2008.
Husbands speak at the age of 30s.
And we communicate through online conversation. And as one of our conversation, He shares with me sometimes with the word of God and asking me some question from the Bible. But sad to say that I can't able to answer his questions, because from my younger age until before I get married, I didn't used to read the Bible, or I don't know about the Bible. I can't even memorize the scripture. So I don't know how to find it, and I don't know how to understand even the verses. So my husband said to me to study and learn and read the Bible so that I will know everything from the Bible, which is the truth, our guide, and our basic instruction before leaving earth. So this would guys kung pwede kay kahibalo. So especially the Bible. So we need to learn, we need to read every day. And last December 18, 2008, my loving husband decided to visit me in person in order to know me well of who I am. And then I think it's just only 1 month to be here in the Philippines during the time. And then before he went back to the US, he proposed me that he wants me to get married, and to get married to him. So asking me if I my permission, and so that is why I agreed the proposal of him. And then he planning to go back here again for our wedding day, and then he will be here before March 8, 2009.
One of our pictures when he first met.
I know that God uses my husband as one of the instrument in order me to know him well, or to have a close personal relationship with God. So when we get married, we had a pastor from a Baptist church to perform our wedding ceremony, since we cannot get married to the Catholic church and even in independent church, because it's Lenten season or holy season that time, and they have full of schedule going on to their church.
One picture when we get married.
And at one time, we attended an event or engagement party of my cousin's daughter, Donette, and with her boyfriend, which is a foreigner. And then my loving husband, John, met a guest pastor during that time, and that he talked to him, and he wanted me to learn and study the Bible. So pastor agreed to him, and my cousin Ate Ida Perpetua heard and knows about what my husband wants. So they set up a Bible study for me to come to the house once in a week, and they went together with our pastor Roger Matundo and with Sister Ida and her husband, Brother Ruben Perpetua, and then Sister Naida and Brother Rumi Tubiu. So, and I think I'm not mistaken, they started Bible for me last June 2009. And then I accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior last July 19, 2009. So after that, they continued sharing with me with the study with the Bible. And then after 7 months, I made a public declaration of my salvation for baptism last February 10, 2010. It's a big surprise for my husband, because it's his birthday during that time, and then it's easy for me to remember that date. Guys, mga kapoy, nagiging English adili guys, pero for the sake of my husband, I have to do it. So now I am adapted into the family of God, and I am a child of God, a Christian, and a Christ follower, because I have God in my life. And now I'm having a greater love, stronger to desire and study His Word and develop a closer walk to Him, because now I belong to Him and desire to continue to serve Him, grow in His Word, that I might be a better disciple. So I'm so grateful and thankful to God for everything and the great things He has done into my life. Salamat Gyud sa Ginoo nga naila ginako siya sa hingpit. And I also thanks to my loving husband, and he's a blessing to me and his life and the things that I've been learned from him, and of course for his love and care for me. Thank you so much. We'd like also to give thanks to Nawana Lion Church family, and to our pastor Roger Matundu, and to my cousin sister Ida Perpetua and her husband Brother Ruben Perpetua, and sister Naida Kalipayan and Brother Romy Tubiu. Thank you for all of you, and you're such a blessing to me. And thank you for your love and for sharing the word of God to me. And I love you all. God bless. So I think I have to end up my video here. So thank you so much for watching with me, and until the next video. I hope guys you have learned something from my video today, and I hope you can also share your story and your testimony. So guys, share with us now. So thank you for watching, and God bless.